class. Well, the purpose of this video is to help demonstrate how you will go through the process of getting your Blackboard Collaborate session set up. I've already created a session, and we're actually going to go there. So I'm going to click on Welcome in the module set, and that'll bring me in my content browser window to Blackboard Collaborate as one of the options, which you'll see at the bottom. Now, you might see more content fill inside of D2L. I'm still building the course shell now, but just go ahead and click on Blackboard Collaborate, and it'll populate different sessions. So at this time, I'm going to have a class overview that I'm going to try and provide starting the first day of class, and I'll send out more information as to the exact time and place. But it'll be online. So go ahead and click on Class Overview, and you'll click Join. Now, what happens is you actually have to download the launcher to be able to utilize this software. Which of these two drop-down options you should choose. So it's pretty self-explanatory here. I'll choose Windows, click Download, and now it's going to actually download the application for Blackboard Collaborate. I see that the download file is showing here. I'm currently using Google Chrome as my browser. And if I click on the icon or the tab option or the button, there we go, that's a good word, button, I'll click Open the file and I click Run. So we're going to run this application. Once we actually run this setup, install, after the setup is done running, then we can click on the Join application. Once you click on the Join button, that's going to have to download something else, which is the actual session. So we'll have to wait for this to finish. So let me pause the video. Okay, so at this point, it finally finished. It took a little bit of time. So this usually takes a little bit of time to download and also to install. Once you click Finish, you're done with the setup process. Now all you have to do is just click Join, and you'll have another item, executable file, download onto your computer. It's the meeting.collab. Once it's done, it'll eventually populate here, so downloading the application, and then choose Run. Don't let it block the application. This is a secure application for this class. And eventually, you'll be brought to the actual Blackboard Collaborate tool. And this is why I suggest, if you are going to join me in the session, that you definitely do this ahead of time, like about 10, 15 minutes, if possible. All right, Windows Firewall has blocked some of the features of Java. All right, allow access. So make sure you have Java updated, and Java might be blocked by Windows automatically. Just choose allow. And then now that you've selected that, you'll have Blackboard Collaborate available here. Choose accept. Choose the cable connection speed that you have, or wireless speed. In this case, I'm actually using LAN connection. Click OK. And give me a second as it populates, and this is essentially what you'll see.